So the next item will flow right into the calling this public hearing to order. Roll call again, please. Can you let the record show Supervisor Savavic, Gassiola, Flair, Ezio, and Fisher are in attendance. And this public hearing is in fact for the consideration of application 2017-0034 or a request for a conditional use approval for the construction of a self-storage facility located at north side of South Point Boulevard and Morganza Road. C1 Zoning District, SPV Holdings LLC applicant. This public hearing was duly advertised on February 7th and the 12th also. And can you please, if we may, have a separate swearing in? Anyone desiring to speak during this hearing?
Please raise your right hands. Each of you do solemnly swear the testimony you're about to give this college to be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, self and God.
I do.
Very well. Sir, may you proceed.
My name is Greg Banner. I'm with the Key Environmental. I'm here representing SPD Holdings in regard to this conditional use application and hearing. What I'd like to do is go through my narrative. If you feel that's the proper thing to do, to enter it into this testimony.
Yes. Bruce, can you take this other down, please? Bruce, are you able to?
I'm sorry?
Are you able to take this other drawing down? Oh, I'm sorry, that's just my
iPad. I'm trying to find it right now.
Thank you.
While Bruce is looking for it, I'll start. Section 403.F of your ordinance requires that all applications for conditional use demonstrate compliance with certain general standards and criteria. What I'm about to present are those standards and how we believe that this project will comply with those standards. Section 907.C.10, a self-storage facility is a conditional use. Excuse me, 403.F.1 is in fact listed as a conditional use within the specific zoning involved. And per 907.C.10 of your ordinance, a self-storage facility is a conditional use in a C1 zoning district. The next item, 403.F.2, will be harmonious with and in accordance with the general objectives or with any specific objective of the township's comprehensive plan. There is a distinct need for self-storage facilities in Cecil Township as a result of the increase in population and the construction of more apartment and condominium units. The location of the proposed site is in keeping with the results of the survey used to craft the 1997 update to the township's comprehensive plan. In that plan, 50% of the respondents to the Citizen Attitude Survey indicated that commercial development should take place in an area surrounding South Point Boulevard. The plan noted that one of the criteria for selecting future commercial areas was for buffering commercial uses from residential uses. The proximity of the proposed self-storage facility would buffer the residential area to the north from potential commercial uses with large numbers of employees and longer hours of operation that could be developed on other portions of the site or on adjacent properties. It is judged that the proposed use is in general conformity with this requirement as a result of the following. Promotes the growth of businesses in the township. It's located within the general commercial district, C1 zoning. In a future land use area, and the self-storage facility is conditional use.
Thanks.
It will protect the residential areas from intrusion and negative impacts from non-residential development and can be developed in an area not yet provided with public sanitary sewer system. 403.F.3 will be designed, constructed, and operated and maintained so as to be harmonious and appropriate in appearance with the existing or intended character of the general vicinity and will not change the essential character of the same area. The property is bordered on the south by South Point Boulevard, on the west by property owned by West Penn Power, and on which two substations and switch yards are located, on the north by undeveloped residentially zoned property and Blue Jay Drive, and on the east by Redford Photography and an undeveloped parcel. There's an overhead electric line, an underlying underground gas and liquid petroleum lines that run east-west through the property. There's also a gas line that runs northeast-southwest through the property. Because of the required side yard setback and the presence of the northeast-southwest trending gas line, the building, proposed building, closest to Blue Jay Drive would be located at least 200 feet to the south. The topography of that portion of the site for the facility slopes from southeast high to northwest low. If we had a figure, we could look at that. The majority of the buildings will be two stories high to take advantage of this natural slope. And we'd also present a cross-section. Hopefully you have that. None of the buildings will be, well, in our original submittal, none of the buildings will be visible from either South Point Boulevard or Morganza Road. We do have the potential to site some buildings at the south end of the property immediately above South Point Boulevard. So there could be visible from South Point Boulevard, but they would not be visible from Morganza Road. The only lighting that's going to be required is for security purposes and will be shielded so as not to result in glare on adjacent properties. The proposed use will not result in the excessive production of traffic. Once the self-storage facility is filled, the trips will be in the range of about 10 to 15 a day. A color scheme will be selected for the facility buildings to allow them to blend to the extent possible into the hillside. Stormwater runoff from the facility will be directed to a subsurface detention facility to control the volume and peak rate of runoff to that of a pre-development condition prior to release on the site. During construction, erosion and sediment control will be governed by an NEPA's general permit for discharge of stormwater from construction activities issued by the Washington County Conservation District. Following construction, stormwater management will be in accordance with an approved post-construction stormwater management plan. All areas of the site not covered by either building footprints or asphalt paving will be permanently landscaped or vegetated. And the buffer area required by section 1506 of the zoning ordinance will be provided along the property lines that buffer the R1 and R3 zoning districts. Okay. As a result of these considerations, it is judged the proposed facility will be designed, constructed, operated, and maintained so as to be harmonious and appropriate in appearance with the existing or intended character of the general vicinity and will not change the essential character of the same area. Section 403.F.4 will not be hazardous or disturbing to existing neighboring uses. There will be no manufacturing or processing materials of any kind. The self-storage facility will not generate any noise, smoke, fumes, glare, or odors. The required yard setbacks will be provided 100 feet where the property borders the R1 and R3 zoning districts. The only lighting, as I mentioned, that will be required will be for security purpose and will be shielded. I mentioned not much traffic. Its facility will be manned between 6 a.m. and 3 p.m. on Friday and 6 a.m. to noon on Saturday. Facility will be closed on Sunday. Renters, however, will have access to the site 24 hours a day through a key card operated gate. As a result of these considerations, it is judged that operation of the proposed facility will not be hazardous or disturbing to existing uses. 403.F.5 will be served adequately by essential facilities and services such as highways, streets, police, and fire protection, drainage structure, refuse disposal, water and sewer, and schools. Where the per persons or agencies responsible for the establishment of the proposed use shall be able to adequately provide any such services. The proposed facility is not residential. There will be no students attending, requiring township transportation. By ordinance, the facility can't be connected to a public sewage system. Sanitary sewage service for the office will be provided by a holding tank. The facility will be surrounded by an 8-foot-high chain link fence. Gate will be operated by a key card. And during the operational times, the site will be manned. We're proposing to access the site by one of two ways. I don't know if this pointer will get up there. The desired route would be to use the existing driveway cut into the site. That currently provides access to West Penn Power and also to the township salt storage area. There's also the potential to use a private drive that comes in from the southeast through the existing South Point Square development. Neither of the two access options are going to require winter upkeep or maintenance from the township. Water service will be extended to the site either from the private drive through South Point Square or from a water line in Blue Jay Drive. As I mentioned, stormwater runoff from the facility will be directed to a subsurface detention facility to control volume and rate of runoff. As a result of these considerations, it is judged the facility will be served adequately by essential facilities and services such as highways, streets, police and fire protection, refuse disposal, and water. 403.F.6 will not create excessive additional requirements of public expense for public facilities and services and will not be detrimental to the economic welfare of the community. The proposed facility is non-residential. There will be no students attending public schools or using township transportation. As I mentioned, by ordinance, the facility can't be connected to a public sewage system. The facility will be surrounded by an 8-foot-high fence. Access will be through a gate with a key card. And access through the facility will either be from the private road through South Point Square or from South Point Boulevard. As a result, judge, the proposed self-storage project will not create excessive additional requirements at public expense for public facilities and services and will not be detrimental to the economic welfare of the community. We're getting near the end. 403.F.7 will not involve uses, activities, processes, materials, equipment, or conditions of operation that will be detrimental to any person, property, or general welfare by reason of excessive production of traffic, noise, smoke, fumes, glare, or odors. As I mentioned before, no manufacturing, processing, or incoming. The facility will not generate noise, smoke, fumes, glare, or odors. The units will be constructed of concrete, concrete block, steel, aluminum, and standard roofing material. The only lighting that will be required will be for security purposes. And the proposed use is not going to result in the generation of excessive traffic. As a result of these considerations, it is judged that operation of the proposed facility will not be detrimental to any persons, property, or the general welfare. Section 403.F.8 will have vehicular approaches to the property, which shall be designed so as not to create interference with traffic on surrounding public thoroughfares. As I mentioned, we're proposing to access site either from South Point Boulevard or through South Point Square. The proposed use will not result in excessive production traffic, about 10 to 15 trips a day following build-out.